Good morning students, how are you all? I hope you all are enjoying the videos of maths. So today we'll start with our chapter number 11, perimeter and area. Please take out your textbook everyone so you can understand it very well. Okay, let me explain you first what is perimeter. Okay, just see here in this diagram a playground is shown to you, right? A tennis court, I think tennis court is shown to you, right? Now if you start walking from this dot and you take a full turn, full round, and you come back to that same place, then the outer boundary which you have walked, that is called its perimeter. Okay, means the distance around the edge of the figure is called its perimeter. The distance around the edge of the figure, in short, the outer boundary of any diagram, any figure, is called its perimeter. And the inside part, the green color inside part, is its area. When I will talk about area, I will explain again what is area. Just now you have to concentrate on only this perimeter, right? Okay, now students, now see here they have shown you one diagram. Okay, now what you have to do, from blue dot you have to start and start counting the lines. Okay, 1 2 3 4, then 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 and 14. 14 is there, so the answer 1 unit means one line means 1 unit. Okay, so answer is perimeter is equal to 14 units. Okay, you have find the perimeter of this square, this rectangle, right? Same way, once again here they have given. Okay, let us start from the same place here, from the corner. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14 15 16 17 and 18. So here perimeter is equal to 18 units, right? This is the way how you have to count the perimeter of any of the shape. Okay, once again here they have shown you, they have already done, but it is wrong somewhere. So let us see how it is wrong. Just see here, 1 2 3. Now see here, they have not written, they have count these two lines as one only, so it is wrong. Okay, what you have to do is, once again we will count here, the same shape is given on both the side. Okay, so here 1 2 3, then 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 and 12. So your actual answer is 12 units. Here they have done two of the ways. Here in 3 also 3 and 4 will come. Here also two lines, instead of that they have counted only one. So this is wrong, and our right answer is 12 units. Okay, same way here again we have to count. Just start from this corner, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12. So perimeter is 12 units. Once again count here, we will start from this way, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 and 12. Again here it is, perimeter is 12 units. See, both the diagrams, both the figures are different, but the answer is same. Okay, so the shape are different, but the perimeter is the same, right? Same way, we have one example is given to you. A maze is there whose side is 50 cm. You have to find the perimeter of that maze board. Okay, perimeter of the board is 50 cm + 50 cm + 50 cm + 50 cm, means total 200 cm. That is your answer. Okay, now turn the page everyone, and we'll start with the exercise number 11A. Here they have given, use a ruler to measure the perimeter of this object in your school bag. Now take out your school diary, pencil box and snack box, and then what you have to do, you have to take a scale and then you have to measure the outside boundary of it. Okay, see here, you have to measure it by your own. I have explained you how to measure the sides. From here you have to start to measure here with the scale. That is your breadth, that is your length, means all four side you measure like this way, and then write the answer of it. Okay, when I will send you the writing part, I will send you the written work. Today I am just explaining you this all. Same way, pencil box, snack box, everything you have to measure and you have to write the total of it. Okay, now here once again second question is given. I am explaining to you what you have to do. You have to take 1 meter long ribbon, and then you have to use the felt pen to mark every 10 cm. Means you have to take a pen, black pen, through which you can mark on the ribbon. Okay, so on the ribbon, every 10 centimeter, you put a mark, one mark. Okay, and that way you make 1 meter long ribbon. Okay, and then you have to measure your. See, at school 3 things are given, at home 3 things are given. It is not possible for you to do at school, but at home it is possible. So you can try the dining table. Take the ribbon and try to measure the dining table's age. Okay, your bed age and your room age. Okay, and then you can find out the perimeter of it. I will show these 2 questions are just for explanation. No need to write in the notebook or in the textbook. Okay, but it was needed to explain, so I have explained you this. Okay, fine. Now then, after what you will do, see, if you are measuring the dining table and if the length, the breadth of a dining table is say 5 meter. Okay, then what you will do, 5 centimeter, then what will come? 5 centimeter plus this side, if it is 10 centimeter, then 5 centimeter plus 10 centimeter plus again 5 centimeter plus again 10 centimeter. Like that, you have to add and you have to find the perimeter of it, right? Okay, now question number 3, find the perimeter of these shapes. Take each square to have side of 1 centimeter. Once again, I am repeating, students, first and second question only for your practice. No, it don't consider is consider it. Okay, now we'll start with this. Here A, B, C and D, 4 different shapes are given to you. You have to find the perimeter. Wherever you start from wherever. See, if we are starting from here, this point, then do a point like this and then start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and 16. So perimeter is 16 centimeter, right? Same way here you have to count. Put a dot and start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 and 20. So perimeter is equal to 20 centimeter. Same way you do this two also. Okay. Let us move to question number 4. Find the perimeter of each of the following. Here, 4 different pictures are given, I could say. Okay. Here it is. First is mobile. Okay. First is mobile, right? In mobile, 6 centimeter, here 6 centimeter, 10 centimeter, 6 centimeter, 10 centimeter. Means they have given the measurement of the sides. Now, what you will do here to find this, you have to just do perimeter is equal to sum of all sides. 6 plus 10 plus 6 plus 10 is equal to, what will be the answer? 6 plus 10, 16, again 6 plus 10, 16. Either you do like this or you can do 10 plus 10, 20 and 6 plus 6, 12. 20 plus 12, it will be 32 centimeter. Okay, this is your answer. Same way here, B is 14, 14, 14, 14. So you can add 14 plus 14 plus 14 plus 14 and then you can find the answer of it, right? Same way here, it is given 18 plus 18 plus 18 plus 18 and here 13 plus 11 plus 6. Okay. Fine. So, like this way you have to find the perimeter of any of the shapes. Okay. Here I am ending with the exercise. Okay. And in my next video, we will continue with the next exercise. Goodbye, everyone.